there's a long board and a short one. And there's, these two have been playing. That one hasn't. That's gonna be my next third board. And that should give me all the sides of the entertainment center, all the sides and some of the face frame and stuff. So then I'll have a back and bottom to come up with and a top, which shouldn't be a problem. All right, I need to, I'm gonna have to join these two. This wasn't wide enough for the bottom that I needed. So how I'm joining these, I've got a biscuit joiner, but I'm about out of biscuits. So there's another way I can do it. I'm gonna take my router and route a groove inside of both of them and cut a quarter inch, basically little thin strips of wood to go in there and glue up. It'll be stronger than a biscuit joiner. These are, this is one of the side panels. These two shorter ones are middle dividers. And I got another side panel that's glued up right here. This is the other side panel. I gotta cut it down and plane it one more time. This is the bottom glued up. They weren't wide enough for what I needed, so I had to add little pieces to them. Alright, so this is what I come up with for the back. I mean, not the prettiest, but I got it finally screwed up. I just got this on top just to keep the side squared up with the bottom and to keep it stable. This is what I'm going to use for the top and the bottom face frame. Once again, piece of old barnwood. I'm definitely going to have to clean this thing down. I don't know how well you can see color on there, but it's got some pretty colors in it. It's got a lime green, like a tan, a dark gray, a reddish auburn. Now I'm going to hold it straight to there, I'm going to hold it down right here, do the same thing. Oh yeah, it's a lot sharper of a, alright, that worked out pretty good. It basically goes to the corner, almost to the top. Alright, let's cut it out with the jigsaw. You can still see the line. So now you take a sander, I'm going to use an orbital sander. For most of it, and then maybe like a piece of sandpaper on something arched a little bit. That'll help. I know it fits. It was in there a while ago. There it goes. All right. So that would then go like that.
Just like that, pumpkins back at Culver's, but not for long. Welcome to Delicious.
We're out there.
Here
we
go.
Lifting. We don't have time to do delicate clothes. We need campus work here. Oh. One of the strongest fabrics around. Carhartt's on Fort, Anderson Boulevard. Everything from the flame resistant canvas pants built to last to the canvas jacket proudly made in the USA.
So I only had a couple of boards that were wide enough, over 13 inches. So I used one, and it wasn't too bad. I mean, it's kind of good looking. There's definitely some character in it. Let's see if I can zoom up. You got some good colors going down through there. About like the rest of it. There's the other door. Got some character in it for sure. Alright, I got pretty much everything done on it. I got my two shelves cut out. I'm just going to pocket screw them. I'm giving it one final sanding right now, so I'm going to sand it all down. And just look at some of these colors. I don't know how well you can see them, but man, are they pretty. Basically got, I don't know, this is like a lime green. I don't know what's showing up. And right to the right, that is like a blue, a bluish color. And of course you got your auburn and tan and your orange colors. This is a beautiful wood. It's poplar barnwood that's been planed down. The doors won't stay shut right now because it's kind of leaning my way, and plus, you know, it's, I don't have no like latches in them yet. But this is it. I still gotta put one shelf in there and one shelf in there, and it should be complete, which I won't be doing that right now anyway. So this is the lid, basically opens up. And I got some goodies that'll be going in there. And then you shut it. And it looks like a piece of